Hello, friends, and welcome to our Wednesday evening prayer time and Bible study. We want to welcome each and every one of you who may be tuning in this evening, and we welcome you in the marvelous, wonderful name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. Now, I'm going to give people just a few moments to begin to come on. I see Miss Marjorie McMillan, so the McMillans are already tuning in, and I appreciate that so much. We'll probably be a little brief tonight in our Bible study, unless the Holy Spirit really gets a hold of the old preacher. Miss Marta is celebrating a birthday today, and so we're going to try to do something a little bit special for her in a few minutes, and take her out to an evening meal. We do want to continue to remember all of those who stand in need of prayer. My goodness, there's so many people who are hurting. See, DeMond from our Virginia brother has come on. We're grateful to see you, DeMond, this evening. Hope things are going well over in Virginia. I expect it's been a little bit cool up that way. But it's good to see you all this evening. If you have a prayer request, let me invite you to go ahead and just type in the comments bar about your prayer request. I know the McMillans has not been feeling well, and I pray that they've recovered and are doing better. DeMond, we'll continue to pray about your Puro and all that you're having to deal with as you deal with that day by day. We'll continue to pray about that and that God will give you victory over that. And I believe victory is on the way. Miss Janie, it's good to see you tuning in. We certainly appreciate you tuning in. We've been missing you. And one day this old virus will get past us and you'll be able to come back. But we're so grateful and thankful that we do have the live stream, and we're grateful for that. Vera said she had her second Moderna shot, a little achy with headaches. That goes along with it. I had that also, achy body, headache, and just kind of felt washed out. But it lasted about a day or two, and then it got better. So, Vera, we'll be praying that you get a little bit better from that second shot. Let's pray for all of those who are suffering with this virus. I know many have been diagnosed, and I believe the numbers are falling somewhat, but let's continue to pray about this. Boy, it'd suit me if the Lord would just move this stuff out of here right now. Amen? Boy, that'd be good. Nancy, good to see you tuning in this evening. We're glad you're here. If all goes well, we'll probably be back in our church setting, in our building next Wednesday night. We'll make that call Sunday morning, but more than likely we will be back in our building next Wednesday evening. We've been doing this live stream now for about a month, so I'm hoping that we'll be able to be back in our building next Wednesday evening. Continue to pray for our church family that's chosen not to attend right now. We're grateful that ways have been made possible that they can get the messages. I got a call from a friend in Texas today who watches our programs, and he wanted to ask how he could get the up-to-date programs. He said he's a little bit behind, so I told him how to go and subscribe to our church page. And Steve, it's good to see you tuning in. We praise God that Steve's able to tune in with us and enjoy a little bit of time of fellowship. Any other prayer requests other than those on our prayer list? Let's pray for our first responders, medical personnel. Let's pray for the leaders of our nation, our state, and our communities, that God would bless them with godly wisdom, not manly wisdom, but godly wisdom, to lead as they should lead according to the way the Scripture teaches. So let's pray for our leaders. Give you just a few more moments. Any other prayer requests? As I said, we come on about 5 minutes early to try to get a few prayer requests, and we going to celebrate Miss Marta's birthday. You know, a pastor that's got a good, godly preacher's wife that supports what God's called him to do is a blessed man, and I have been so blessed. Miss Marta supports me 100%, and she supports what I do for the Lord, and sometimes when I don't feel like doing for the Lord, she pushes me to do for the Lord anyway. And just a marvelous preacher's wife, and I love her so much. So I'm going to try to help her celebrate her birthday this evening. Dennis, good to see you tuning in. Well, let's go to the Lord in prayer, and we'll get right into our Bible study and see what the Lord's going to say to us this evening. Father, we love you, and how we praise you and thank you for the opportunity you give us to search the truth of your word. God, I pray that as we look at it for just a few moments this evening, that you would use this message to encourage us and to carry us through these gloomy, dark times of unrest. Lord, I pray for those who are suffering. Lord, I lift Vera up to you. She took that second shot, and she's feeling achy with headaches, and I just pray you'll help her and strengthen her to get past that. And Heavenly Father, we continue to pray for Miss Carol and her mother, Lord, that you'll just continue to bless her and be with her. Father, we pray for Damon, that you would just continue to just lift him up. And God, I don't know what you may be going to do with him, but I believe he's got a special call in his life to do something for you. And whatever that is, we trust you will take him and use him for your glory. Thank you for what he's doing in his church in Virginia. And thank you, dear Lord, that he tunes in, and we just consider him to be a part of our little work in Adel, Georgia. So, Lord, we thank you for him. Father, we thank you for all of those of our people that's been able to make it back to the little house of prayer on Sunday morning. We praise you for their lives and just ask you to bless them. We pray for those who's not been able to make it back just yet because of the pandemic. We thank you, dear Lord, for making Facebook Live possible for us and to where they can get a message from their church. We just praise you for that. We ask you to bless them with safety and care for them, Lord, as we continue to deal with the pandemic. Lord, we pray for medical personnel. We pray for hospitals, doctors, nurses. We pray for paramedics, EMTs. We pray for first responders who deal with this on a daily basis. Lord, we ask you to bless them. We pray for our nation's leaders and our state leaders and our local leaders that you give them godly wisdom in Christ Jesus to do what's necessary to help us to be better, a better people in a better country. God, we pray that as we break the bread of life and look into your word for just a few moments, that it'll be an encouragement to us. Continue, O Lord, to use our little lighthouse in our community to spread the light of Jesus Christ. We thank you for the Gordon Avenue Baptist Church and its fellowship and its membership. And then, Lord, we thank you for those outside of our membership that's beginning to tune in. And it thrills me, dear Father, that we got people watching all over this country and how good it is. And then, Lord, to follow our podcast, Lord, there's people all over the world that's getting a message from a little small Baptist church in Adel, Georgia. We thank you for that. Now, Lord, use the preacher tonight to say those words you'd have him to say. Couldn't do it without you. I need you, oh Lord. So speak that your people may hear in Jesus' name. Amen. Let me invite you for just a moment to take your Bibles and turn with me over to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 11. Miss Patricia, I see you've tuned in. How good it is to see that you're tuning in with us. Matthew's Gospel, chapter number 11. I want us to look at three verses of Scripture as our text verses of Scripture. And then I want to bring you a simple little message that I've titled, It's Time to Come to Jesus. It's time to come to Jesus. Notice, if you will, beginning with verse 28, Jesus says here, Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Father, bless these words, Lord. Use them for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Friend, if there's ever been a time that people need to come to Jesus, it's now. You know, we run and go to and fro. We're always coming and we're always going. But Jesus gives to us a blessed invitation. He simply says, come unto me. I like what the Lord said when he said, I stand at the door and knock. And if anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I'll come in and sup with him, he with me. Fellowship with him, he with me. God's greatest desire is to have fellowship with you. And friend, we need that right now. Whenever we think about how dark times seem to be, how much civil unrest there seems to be in our nation, we need to come to the Lord. It's time to come to Jesus. There's four reasons that I want to share with you that I believe that we need to come to Jesus. First of all, my friend, there is help in his person. There is help in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, whenever I begin to think about that, and I see that Ginger has turned on and said, Miss Carolyn's listening, praise God. Good to have Miss Carolyn listening in. But listen, there's help in the person of Jesus. He says, come. You know, children are summoned to their mother. When injured or hurt or distressed or upset, they run to mama for soothing comfort. You and I, as children of God, we're summoned to run to our Savior. When we're burdened and the load seems to be more than we can bear, we need to run to our Savior. When the load is heavy and it's a heavy laden and it's more than we can bear, we need to run to our Savior. We need to receive the soothing comfort that only our Savior can give. The prophet Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 13, shout for joy. Shout for joy, you heavens. Earth, rejoice. Mountains, break into joyful shouts. For the Lord has comforted his people and will have compassion on his afflicted ones. How grateful and thankful we are that, friends, in times like these, we can rush and run to the Lord just as fast as we can. You know, my friend, sometimes we try to run everywhere except where we ought to run. We're running to and fro, trying to get the help that we seemingly feel like we need. And the greatest person that we could ever run to is Jesus. Jesus' blessed invitation, come unto me. So there's help in the person of Jesus. Secondly, there's strength in the presence of Jesus. If you'll notice, he says, take my yoke. So he says to us, take. Recall Jesus on the way to the cross. Think about that for just a moment. His burden seemed to be more than he could bear. In fact, he gave way under the load of the cross. And Simon the Cyrenian carried his cross to Calvary. Friend, you find that in Matthew 27, 32. The Bible said they called or found a Cyrenian man named Simon, and they forced him to carry the cross of Jesus. You know, I can just imagine how it must have been if there had been an NBC or an ABC or a CBS News broadcast going on at this particular event. I can just see them as they would interview Simon and say, Simon, what in the world was it like to have to carry such a heavy cross for a man that was condemned? What was it like? I believe old Simon would have probably shouted at them and said, well, glory to God, I couldn't feel the weight of the cross for the touch of his hand. Amen. Feeling the touch and the strength of God's hand gave him the strength to carry the load of the cross. Sometimes burdens are heavy. How many of you know that? I believe that we all do. Sometimes burdens are more than we can bear. Well, Jesus invites us to enter his yoke. Jesus invites us to let him help us. So, friend, all we've got to do is rely upon his strength and his presence to get us through anything that we'll ever face in this life. Friend, you won't ever face anything alone whenever you trust the Lord with all your heart and you lean not to your own understanding. So there's help in his person and there's strength in his presence. But then thirdly, there's hope in his knowledge. If you'll notice the text verse again, he says, "Take my yoke upon you and learn of me." One of the greatest things that you and I can do is to learn from the Lord. Friend, we need to learn from him. Now, you've got to be a teachable vessel before you can learn anything. You've got to be taught. And friend, if you're being taught the Word of God and you're beginning to learn more about Jesus, you're headed down in the right direction. Now, listen, what do we need to learn about Jesus? Well, let me share with you three things that I think we need to learn about Jesus. First of all, he's meek and lowly in heart. Now, meekness don't mean weakness. He's meek and lowly in heart. Secondly, he did not come to condemn. We're very swift and quick to condemn. We'll point a finger at any given moment at anyone. But the Lord didn't come to condemn. He said that God did not send his son into the world that he might condemn the world, but that through him the world might be saved. So friend, he came to save the world. And that's the greatest gift that God has ever given. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. So he's meek. He didn't come to condemn. And thirdly, you need to understand he came to save the world. God sent his Son that the world might be saved through him. So we learned that about Jesus. Three great things. He's meek and humble in heart. He did not come to condemn. Thirdly, he came to save. Now, you know, whenever I begin to think about that, I cannot help but be blessed. What do we need to do about Jesus? Well, that's a pretty good question. What do we need to do about Jesus? Well, we need to come unto him. That's what the scripture says, come unto him. How do you do that? Well, the Spirit of God draws you, and you accept him as your personal Savior. Remember, the Bible says that he stands at the door and that he knocks. And if anyone will hear his voice and open the door, that he'll come in and sup with him, have dinner with him, have fellowship with him. And then you need to discover, once you've accepted him as Lord and Savior, you need to discover that he is your hope. Friend, outside of the Lord Jesus Christ, there is no hope. I hope you heard that. Outside of the Lord Jesus Christ, we have no hope. I mean, many have taken vaccines. I've taken vaccines in hope that things can get better. But friend, the greatest hope that you'll ever have and can possess is hope in the Lord Jesus Christ. Our hope is in him. The psalmist said in Psalm 78, verse 7 and 8, listen to what he said. He said, so that they might put their confidence in God and not forget his works. One of the greatest things that you can do is put your confidence in God. My friend, put your confidence in God and never forget his works. Friend, just think with me for just a moment. Think about his works. He spoke this world into existence. He created man out of the dust of the earth and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. He provided a lamb without spot or blemish that would buy us back from the sin that we committed in the Garden of Eden. Oh, my friend, what a loving God he is. Never forget his works. But then the Bible says we need to keep his commandments. Do those things that he says to do. Then they would not be like their fathers, a stubborn and rebellious generations whose heart was not loyal and whose spirit was not faithful to God. Friend, the greatest thing that you and I can do is be faithful to God. So, friend, as we think about this, coming to Jesus, it's time to come to Jesus. Why? Because there's help in his person, there's strength in his presence, and glory to God, there's hope in his knowledge. But then there's a fourth thing that I want you to see in this. There's rest in his invitation. There's rest in his invitation. Learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest for your souls. There's rest in his invitation. Ye shall find, listen, it says, ye shall find rest unto your souls. There's rest in our Lord's blessed invitation. The word rest appears twice in this particular text, in verse 28 and in verse 29. Jesus said, I will give you rest. Verse 29, Jesus says, and ye shall find rest. These promises have one condition. Preacher, what is that condition? I'm waiting. I know you are. Let me just reiterate that one more time. These promises for rest have one condition. That condition is come unto me. Friend, you'll never find rest outside of Jesus. There are many people who try to find rest in an alcohol bottle, and it brings peace of mind for just a little while, but then when you begin to sober up, you find yourself tormented again. Some people try to find rest in a pill bottle or drugs. Other people try to find rest in riches. Other people try to find rest in jobs. Other people try to find rest. And the list could just go on and on and on. But if you really want to find true rest, friends, you need to come to Jesus. Now, when you come to Jesus, you find comfort. When you come to Jesus, you find overflowing manna from heaven. When you come to Jesus, you find the means to carry on in this life. When you come to Jesus, you find everything that you will ever need to carry on in this old world. Four things, four important things. It's time to come to Jesus. There's help in his person. There's strength in his presence. There's hope in his knowledge, and there's rest in his invitation. As I bring this thing to a close, Jesus gives comfort like no one else can. I've been doing this for a long time, and I've stood by the bedside of many people who left this world, and I've stood next to their families trying to bring compassion and comfort, just to feel like a complete failure when I walked out of that home. But friend, the Lord will never fail you. He'll give you comfort like no one else can. He'll provide a cup that runs over. Did you hear that? He'll provide a cup that runs over. He'll give more than enough. He'll provide the means and the meaning for your life. He is everything that you will ever need. Will you come to him and find true rest? No better one to come to and find true rest. Great Bible study this evening. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. The blessed invitation of our Lord has never changed. It's still come. The question is, friend, will you come? It's time to come to Jesus. It'll make a difference in your life, I'll guarantee you. Pray with me. Father, thank you for this wonderful message that reminds us that your invitation is simply come. And that's all you want us to do is just come. Lord, you'll take us right where we are. Now, you may not leave us where we are, but you'll take us right where we are. So many people, Lord, say, well, you know, when I can make some changes, I'll come to Jesus. And Lord, they'll never come because, God, we don't have the power to make change. You'll take us right where we are. You'll take the filthy stains of sin that we're wrapped up in. You'll take us right there where we are. And then, Lord, you'll save us. And you'll begin to make the changes that need to be made. And when you make the changes, they'll be for the good. I pray for that one, Lord, who is fearful this evening, that you'll help them overcome their fear by coming to you. I pray for that one who may be hurting this evening, that you'll help them overcome their hurt by coming to you. I pray for that one, Lord, who may be wrapped up in the stench of sin. Lord, you can heal that if they'll just come to you. Your invitation has never changed, nor will it ever. It's still come. Come, just as I am, without one plea, I come. And then, Lord, I ask you to take the vessel and make it into what you want it to be. In Jesus' name, amen. Friend, the greatest encouragement you'll ever find is Jesus. He'll carry you through anything you ever face in this life. Invitation is come, and we invite you to do just that. Come to Jesus. Well, hallelujah. What a great Bible study. Friend, let me invite you, those of you who may be in our Adel area, to come to the Little House of Prayer Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. We're not doing Sunday school at this particular time. We sing a couple of songs, and then we get right into the pages of God's precious word and preach the glorious gospel of the Lord Jesus. So let me invite you to come to the Little House of Prayer. We're still trying to social distance a little bit and wearing face masks to try to protect one another. But we welcome you and would invite you to come and worship with us at Gordon Avenue Baptist Church. Look forward to seeing you Sunday morning, 10:30 a.m., Gordon Avenue Baptist Church. God bless you. And have a good evening.